Hello students, welcome to Dynamics of Machinery, Module 4. In the previous class, we have studied about the gyroscopic couple and we have solved two problems based on the gyroscopic effect. Okay. In this class, we are going to solve a problem based on gyroscopic couple on an airplane. Here in this picture you could see a plane, airplane. So this portion, this front side is called as nose. So this front part is called as nose, okay, and this rear part is called as tail. Okay, front part is called as nose, rear part is called as tail. Okay, so imagine you are looking from this side, you are looking the plane from this side. Okay, that is, you are looking the plane from the tail, you are looking the plane from the tail. When you are looking the plane from the tail, this engine shaft is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction. This engine shaft is rotating in the clockwise direction like this. Okay, this engine shaft is rotating in the clockwise direction. Okay, at the same time, the airplane is trying to turn in the clockwise direction. Sorry, anti-clockwise direction. Initially, the engine shaft is rotating in the clockwise direction. But airplane is trying to turn. Plane is trying to turn in the anti-clockwise direction. So what will happen? The nose will rise and tail will dip. That means nose will go up, tail will go down. In a simple way, engine direction and plane's rotating direction are opposite, means nose will rise, tail will fall. Okay, otherwise engine is rotating clockwise and plane is trying to turn anti-clockwise. Otherwise engine is rotating anti-clockwise and plane is trying to turn clockwise, means the nose will go up and the tail will go up. Simply a kind of takeoff. Okay, during takeoff the engine will rotate in the engine will try to rotate otherwise it is flying in the sky, but still it want to go up. Okay, still they want to increase the elevation. Already the plane is flying in the sky and still they want to increase the elevation, means what they will do means the engine direction and the flight direction, they will make it as opposite to each other. If engine is rotating in the clockwise, means flight will go in the anti-clockwise direction. If engine is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, means flight will go in the clockwise direction. Okay, if they make it like that, means nose will go up and tail will go down. Okay, this is the effect of gyroscope. Okay, this is the effect of gyroscopic couple. Okay, this is the effect of gyroscopic couple. So here also we are going to solve a problem. The same thing we already know in the previous problem itself, we know this gyroscopic couple equal to I omega omega p, where I is mass moment of inertia, m k square. Okay, k means radius of gyration, m mass means mass of the engine or propeller, mass of the propeller. Okay, and v is the linear velocity of the airplane, r is the radius of curvature, and omega p, that is angular velocity of precession, is v by r. V by r. For example, so here we have a plane model. Okay, here we have a plane model. Okay, and this plane is trying to turn this side, and this plane is trying to turn this side. If it trying to turn this side, means, so based on what center, suppose if it is a center, and at this angle it is turning, means, so this radius, this is called radius of curvature. Okay, radius of curvature. And at what speed it is turning, at what speed it is turning, that is called velocity. See, this is different. This is velocity of the, this is the speed of propeller, this is omega, but this is omega p. Propeller speed is omega. At what speed it is turning, total flight is turning, that is called omega p. At what speed engine is running, that is omega. At what speed the total flight is turning, that is called omega p. Okay, in which direction engine is running, suppose if it is clockwise, means clockwise. At which direction flight is turning, suppose if it is anti-clockwise direction, means anti-clockwise direction. So here they are opposite in direction. Engine is running in clockwise direction, but flight is turning in anti-clockwise direction. So the front portion of the flight will go up, the rear portion of the flight will go down because of the gyroscopic couple. Okay, similarly here propeller, that is this engine or propeller. Okay, this fan, that is called as propeller. Okay, this propeller is attached with the engine. So here engine is rotating in the counterclockwise direction. Here engine is rotating in the counterclockwise direction. Otherwise, this propeller is rotating in the counterclockwise direction, but flight is turning in the clockwise direction. Flight is turning in clockwise direction. You are looking from this side. Begin. You are looking from the begin side. Okay. When you look from this side, you are seeing the propeller which is rotating in this direction. Okay, rotating in this direction. But total flight is turning in this direction. If it happen like this, means, sorry, small mistake. Propeller is also rotating in clockwise direction, and plane is also trying to turn clockwise. Propeller is also rotating clockwise. Plane is also trying to turn clockwise. They are in same direction. Propeller rotating direction and plane turning direction, they are both are in same direction. If both the directions are same, means this nose will go down and tail will go up, kind of learn takedown process. Okay, kind of takedown process. If both propeller and the plane, they are turning in same direction, means the front portion, nose will go down, and the tail portion, back portion, will go up. Okay, well, suppose propeller and the plane, they are turning in opposite direction, means nose will go up and tail will go down. That's all. We'll solve the problem based on this. the same thing they have given here. Okay, when the propeller rotates in anti-clockwise direction and the airplane takes a right turn, then nose will rise, tail will dip. Yeah, but propeller is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, but it is taking the left turn. Flight is taking the left turn means nose will dip, plane tail will rise. Okay, right. So it's all one problem. An airplane makes a complete half circle of 50 meter radius towards left. Okay, so let us write the given data. So the radius of turning or radius of curvature is 50 meter. Okay, an airplane makes a complete half circle of 50 meter radius towards left. Okay, when flying at 200 kilometer per hour. Okay, when flying at 200 kilometer per hour, the turning speed is 200 kilometer per hour. We have to change it to velocity is 200 kilometer per hour. And mass is 400 kg. And radius of gyration is 0.3 meter. So already told, no, radius r is 50 meter, and then radius of gyration k value equal to 0.3 meter, mass value 400 kg, and velocity 200 kilometer per hour. So they are given in 200 kilometer per hour. We have to change that to meter per second. Okay, 200 kilometer per hour. If you change it to meter per second, means it will become 55.6 meter per second. Okay, what is they given? The engine speed, N they have given. N value is 2400 RPM. So omega value will be 2 pi n by 60. The value is 251.4 radian per second. Okay, so substitute all the values in the formula. I equal to mk square, you got I value. Then omega p equal to v by r, 1.11. Then omega value 251. Substitute all the values, you will get couple value. Okay, what they have told us to find, the question is find the gyroscopic couple on the aircraft and state its effect on it. We have to find out the gyroscopic couple. Okay, we got it. We got the gyroscopic couple. Then they are asking, what is the condition of plane? Whether it is moving in the upward direction or moving in the downward direction, or whether the nose, the front portion, is in the upward direction, moving in upward direction or downward direction, whether the tail portion, backside, is moving in the upward direction or downward direction, that they are asking. How we can find out that? Very easy. We know that when the airplane turns towards left and rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, okay, clockwise direction. So
as a cursor.
So this is the front side, okay? This is the front side. So front side is rotating in the clockwise direction. Front side is rotating in when you view. This is tail, okay? When you view from the tail, when you this is tail and this is nose. When you view from the tail, when you view from the tail, this propeller is rotating in the clockwise direction. Okay, propeller is rotating in the clockwise direction. Like this clockwise direction, but the flight plane is turning in the left side, leftward. The plane is turning leftward. Plane is turning leftward. Propeller is rotating clockwise, so they are opposite to each other. The directions are opposite to each other, so the nose will go in the upside and the tail will dip down. Nose will go upward and tail will dip down. We'll solve one more problem. An airplane flying at 240 km per hour turns towards the left and completes a quarter circle of 60 meter radius. The mass of the rotary engine and the propeller of the plane is 450 kg and the radius of variation is 320 mm. The engine speed is 2000 rpm clockwise when viewed from the rear. Determine the gyroscopic couple on the aircraft and state this effect. Airplane turns towards right. Okay, this is one condition. In what way is the effect changed when the airplane turns towards right? Second condition, engine rotates clockwise when viewed from the front and the airplane turns left or right. This is their question. Okay, we will solve it. First of all, let us write the given data. So what are the given data they given? First, they given the airplane flying at velocity they given. Okay, velocity value is 240 km. Per hour, we have to change it to meter per second. To change it to meter per second, multiply the value. First of all, we have to convert the kilometer into hour. Sorry, kilometer into meter. First of all, we have to convert the kilometer into meter. For that, multiply with the 1000. Okay. Then convert the hour into second. To convert the hour into second, multiply with the 60 into 60. 1 hour equal to 3600 seconds. Yeah, that's what I have written here. Now find the velocity value. Okay. Then what is they given? They given the mass value. Okay, mass value is 450 kg. Then they given radius of gyration, K value, 320 mm. Convert it into meter. If you convert it into meter, means 0.32 meter. Then they given engine speed. Engine speed is 2000 rpm. Then find the omega value, 2 pi n by 60. 2 pi n by 60. Find omega p value. Omega p value is velocity by radius of curvature. Okay, substitute all the values. Find mi value. I equal to mk square. Substitute m value and substitute k value. So we have all the value. Now what is the formula for c? That is gyroscopic couple. I omega omega p. Substitute all the values and enter inside this formula. You will get couple value. See, they have substituted all the values and finally they got couple as 10.713 kilonewton per meter. Actually, they got 10,730 newton meter, Now they have changed this newton into kilonewton. So they have put dot here and converted it into kilonewton. They have taken three powers, 10.713 kilonewton meter. So we got the value. Now we have to find out the directions for each condition. Wait, let me erase it. Okay, I have erased it. So totally they have given three conditions. First condition, they are looking from the back side. They are looking from the back side and they are telling that engine is rotating in the clockwise direction. Engine is, so if it is a flight means, and this is front portions, and this is front nose, and this is tail. They are looking from this side. When you look at from this side, engine is rotating clockwise and plane is taking a right turn. Plane is taking a right turn like this. So what will happen? Both are in same direction. Engine also rotating in the clockwise direction. Plane is also taking right turn. So what will happen? In the first condition, nose will go in the downward direction and tail will go in the upward direction. In the first case, nose will dip, tail will rise. Yeah. For first case, you have to write nose will go downward direction and tail will rise. This is first condition. First case. Okay. Now we will go for second condition. Condition number one. We will go for second condition. In second condition, you are looking from the front side. You are looking from the front side. And when you look at from the front side, engine is rotating clockwise. When you are looking from the front side, engine is rotating clockwise. Clockwise means like this. Engine is rotating clockwise. Okay, well. But plane is turning left. Case A. Plane is turning left means from front portion. When you look at from the front side, plane is turning left means this side. Okay, so both are in same direction. So for case A, nose will dip, nose will dip and the tail will rise for case A. For case B, this is A, this is case A. Okay, this is case A. For case B, you are looking from the front side and engine is rotating clockwise like this. Engine is rotating clockwise and plane is turning to the right side. In this side, plane is turning to the right side, that means opposite direction. If it is in opposite direction, means what you write, nose will go up and tail will go down. That's all. Okay, this is how we have to solve the problem. Solve both the problems. In the next class, we will solve one problem from ship. Okay.